Hi guys, so you know, it's been a while since I've done like a love update. So I don't know, today I was just getting pulled to do that. So the topic that I want to cover today is, what does your person want to tell you right now? Okay, I'm going to be shuffling the cards on camera and we'll see what they want to tell you. Okay, so there are three groups. I want you to choose from these crystal eggs. I think this one is the sunstone. I'm not very sure. I think it's the sunstone. This one, okay, I'm going to just use, like, this is the orange stone because I'm not very sure about the names of these. And this is like the black stone with like some spots on it. That's pile two. And pile three is, this I know. This is the rose quartz, right? The pink stone. So we have orange, black and pink. I want you to keep the topic in mind. What does your person want to tell you right now? And pick your stone. And we'll start. Pause your videos if you want. Right guys, so let's start with our orange stone or the sunstone, whatever you want to call it, if it only stays up. Okay, right guys, I'm going to shuffle on screen. So let's see what comes up. What does pile one's person want to tell them right now? Okay, let's just see these two. Oh, 10 of cups. And four of pentacles. All right guys, so with these two cards, I'm seeing that, you know, your person, pile number one, they want the 10 of cups with you. Okay, that's what they want to tell you, that they are visualizing like a 10 of cups with you. They want the whole hog. They can see a beautiful life ahead with you, maybe with children, a house, you know, full emotional contentment. But they're not able to tell you this. They're not able to tell you this dream. With this four of pentacles, your person is keeping this hidden within themselves. All right, now let us see what is the reason that your person, I mean, this is very plain and simple. Your person visualizes the 10 of cups. You are the 10 of cups for this person, but they're holding tight. They're holding on very tight to this dream, this hope, or these feelings about you. Your person is not ready to tell you guys about this at this time. So let's see. Why are they not being able to tell you this? Okay, we had a flip. What is that? Let's see. I don't do reversals, so. Okay, so five of cups and I hope you can see these cards. Yeah, okay, five of cups and knight of wands. All right, okay, so I'm seeing two things here. The reason why your person is holding back right now in sort of going forward, charging forward with you, is because you know, this person, they might have faced something. Okay, they might have faced something very tough in their connections at one point of time. Maybe this person went through a broken connection or some heartbreak, something like that. However, they are noticing you, but they don't want to jump the gun. And that's what I'm getting. This person doesn't want to jump the gun and just go ahead right now, because it would be like too much for this person to handle. Because, you know, 10 of wands at the bottom of the deck, right? So this person's kind of just about getting out of something, okay? And they've just started noticing you. With the 9 of wands, I'm sensing that this person is very is feeling a lot of attraction for you, sexual attraction for you, okay? They don't want to sort of, you know, like let the passion blind them in making you know, like a choice or a decision before the time has come, right? This person wants to understand, what is this 2 of cups, right? You know, what is this feelings? Because there are feelings here. We have 2 cups cards here, so there are feelings here, right? But then this person has lost so much, they don't want to lose this as well, just because, you know, they are in this big hurry or they're feeling this intense attraction towards you. So your person wants to tell you, pile one, that you know, they don't want to hurry up you know, a decision, or they don't want to make a decision which is based only on passion or desire or lust or something like that. Because this person is looking for a long term. They are serious. They want emotional contentment. They have not been very happy, or they've been hurt in the past. They're still getting out of it. They're still healing from it. And that is why your person doesn't want to hurry. Okay. Now let's see some more. What else do they want to tell you? What else does pile one's person want to tell them? Okay. Yeah, 6 of swords. Like I was saying, you know, this person's still healing. They are still healing from, you know, maybe a past connection or a marriage that didn't work out. And there is this, a large amount of passion they feel for you, they're feeling for you. And they don't want to be blinded. You know, maybe this person might be thinking that, you know, they're on a rebound and they don't want to, like, you know, give you some sort of false hopes or expectations. They don't want to, you know, themselves sort of, you know, like get blinded by the passion. So yeah, your person is kind of holding back because they're still healing, pile number one. Okay, now let's see, what else do they want to tell you? Okay. Yeah, we have the star, right? So yeah, this person wants to tell you that yes, apart from the healing element of this connection, I feel that your person thinks that, you know, you are their guiding star, their hope, their wish, their desire. Okay, they don't want to spoil this, all right? Your person doesn't want to spoil this. There's a lot of purple here, if you can see. So this looks like a spiritual sort of connection to me. And they don't want to sully it, is what I'm hearing, okay? I'm actually hearing they don't want to, you know, sully the pureness of this connection with you. They see you as this, you know, beautiful hope and wish fulfillment for them. You know, it's like the light at the end of the tunnel. They have noticed this 2 of cups with you, but they want to sort of, you know, like be at a very calm and a very balanced place in their life before they come towards you. Okay, now what else? Okay, we have Knight of Pentacles, yes, your person is slow. Okay, I mean, they are trying to take it slow, at least that's what I feel, because here we have the Knight of Wands, right? But this person doesn't want to be like, you know, someone who comes in and swoops you up and then says bye-bye later on. You know, they don't want to hurry it up. They want to be slow yet steady. This person is looking for like a long-term thing here, and they don't want to stumble, they don't want to run away. They are basically loyal people, dependable people. They want to be that for you because they sense that you are the star, okay, that you deserve something very steady, you deserve something very beautiful, like the ten of cups here. And they don't want to, like, you know, rush anything right now, because, you know, they feel you deserve so much more. Yeah, Four of Wands. This is what I was talking about. They want to get married to you. I mean, you know, like, this person is looking at you like, you know, as a future prospect. We have two number fours here, okay, which means this is a very stable and dependable sort of person, or at least they want to be that way for you. I mean, after whatever they have faced in their life, this person wants a very steady sort of connection with you, you know, something that is you know, that gives light not just to both of you, that gives happiness not just to both of you, but to a lot of people. This person is wanting, like, you know, with the ten of cups and the four of wands here, this person is wanting a marriage here, a marriage, a celebration, you know, like the whole hog, basically. And that is the reason why your person wants to tell you that they are being slow and steady, because they don't want to rush and spoil anything. They want everything to be perfect. You know, with the Four of Wands, I'm sensing that your person wants a very beautiful celebration, like a lovely wedding celebration perhaps, or a very solid and steady and happy and peaceful home. They are actually looking, I'm sensing that, you know, your person is actually looking at tying a lot of strings, like, you know, they want to act only when it is the right time, when everything is looked after, when they have worked out everything in their life. That is when this person would want to make a move towards you. And then Six of Cups, yes, they also want to tell you that they're looking forward to some sort of a meeting with you. Now, I'm not sure if you guys are in communication, perhaps with the Four of Pentacles, your person might be a bit withdrawn right now. You know, like with the Six of Swords and the Four of Pentacles, it's possible that your person is a bit withdrawn right now. And they are wanting to tell you that, you know, they are going to be coming soon with news or with communication about, you know, meeting up, right? There is something about a meeting up. They also want to tell you that they find you, like, Six of Cups is the, you know, the card of soulmates, right? So this person feels this familiarity. Four of Wands, Six of Cups, Ten of Cups. This person finds that you are their soulmate, right? Here also we have Two of Cups, right? So, you know, the feeling that I'm getting is that your person is they are like boiling inside, okay? They want to tell you so much, but it's like they're trying very hard to control themselves. They're trying very hard to sort of, you know, like walk step by step to get to you. But they find that you are their soulmate, okay? They feel that, you know, their soul feels that, and they are looking forward to some sort of a meeting. They want to rush forward and maybe travel to you and have some sort of a meeting or something like that, you know, maybe to set things in motion. But for the moment, I sense your person is in some sort of healing mode, or you know, facing something. Let's see why your person is let's see some more. Yeah, Nine of Wands. They are a bit, I'm sensing they're a bit, you know, like hesitant. They are kind of like blocked off right now, maybe because this healing is taking place. Maybe you feel they're blocked off, but they want to tell you that, you know, actually it's not, it's at the bottom of the deck we have the Sun. It's not that, it's not you, okay? It's not you. It's like this person right now cannot face the full, you know, positivity of the Sun, the joy, the happiness, you know, because they are still healing. Let me clarify, let me clarify this Five of Cups, like what really happened to your person. Ace of Cups. The Lovers, King of Wands, and Two of Pentacles. Interesting. Yeah, guys, I think your person in the past, I sense, has sort of, you know, rushed into some connection, you know, with a lot of passion. I think your person is like a fire sign or something mostly, because I'm seeing a lot of wands here. I think this person sort of, you know, rushed into something because of passion, okay? And then when they sort of got into the connection, this person, you know, was very confused whether they really wanted this or not, right? I think that is the reason. And yeah, at the top of the deck we have the Emperor, and at the bottom of the deck we have the Nine of Cups. So yeah, I think this person kind of, you know, was very attracted. I think this person's passion meter is like really high, okay? So, you know, this person got really attracted to a previous connection, went into it, and then could not like decide. And maybe that is the reason the connection kind of broke up, because they were not stable enough. They were not sure enough, right? And that's the reason your person doesn't want to repeat, you know, that kind of thing with you right now, okay? That is the reason this person is like, you know, blocked off and, you know, holding back. So let's see, what are they going to do in the future? Yeah, we have Six of Cups again. Yes, like I was saying, you know, this person wants, is planning to come and meet you. They want to come and meet you. They want to confess something to you, you know. Yeah, and they are sort of like, you know, dilly-dallying about it a little bit. Like, how do they come and do that? What is it that they need to tell you? You know, something like that. Yeah, with the Four of Cups here, this person is kind of, you know, feeling a bit despondent. I'm seeing, like, it's like spirit is showing them something, but, and they are tuning in, right? They are tuning in about what to do here, right? This person is in deep thought. Perhaps they are also feeling, you know, they're not feeling very good about holding back. I'm sensing they're not feeling very good about holding back. And yeah, the passion is high, guys. The passion is very high with this person. They're extremely attracted to you. And they're very convinced about you as well. You know, with the King of Wands here, they're very convinced about you, pile number one, right? But with the Queen and with the Queen of Pentacles here, like I said, you know, this person might be wanting to make you their partner, their future spouse, or you know, something like that. Because with the Ten of Cups and then, you know, with the Queen of Pentacles, you know, this person wants to do something serious is what I'm getting, okay? Your person, pile number one, is holding back right now. That's what they want to tell you, because in the past, this person has you know, kind of rushed it in the area of love and been disappointed themselves, or they've disappointed someone else, and they're not a bad person, okay? And they don't want to be the bad person in front of you as well, for you as well, and that's why they are just asking you to be a little patient right now. I'm going to use the oracle as well. Okay, let's see. Oh, that's too much. I'm sorry. It's way too much, guys. Okay. I had the card Yin drop out. So yes, your person wants you to be receptive right now. Okay, to be soft with them, because you know, it's not like they're not convinced. This person is very convinced about you. With the King of Wands here, this person's very convinced about you. They want you to know that, but they want you to be a little more patient, a little more receptive, because you know, they are still trying to decide on you know, when to come to you, what to tell you, how to confess their feelings to you. I am sensing a very, it's like this means a lot to your person. Okay, confessing their feelings to you means a lot to this person, and they're thinking about how to do that. I sense they do want to come and meet you face to face and then tell you, because I don't think this person wants to do it on a message or something like that. I'm not getting anything like that here. This is a person, once they make up their mind, you know, they are going to face it. So they're just trying to find out, a, you know, like a course of action. They want you to be receptive, guys, at this time, okay? Number two is also the number of partnership. This is also the color pink, which is a lot of love here. They want you to treat them or see them, if you're interested, of course. They want you to see them with the eyes of love, be a little receptive, and, you know, sort of leave it to them. I mean, you know, you don't have to do anything here. I sense pile number one, leave it to them. All right. The other two cards that dropped out, yeah, go the distance. Like I was saying, guys, this person wants to go the distance. They want a strong connection with you. All right. They want to sort of, you know, like go for the whole hog with the Ten of Cups and, you know, with this go the distance card. They want to, they have strong feelings. And they don't want some sort of, you know, like a fling or a casual connection. They want to go the distance here. They want to test their strength as well as the resilience of this connection, right? So this person wants to tell you that they are looking at the long run, all right? Now with the Observer card, I'm seeing that maybe your person has, you know, like, they are looking at you, they're probably watching your social media, they have their eye on you. They're also very tuned into their intuition, okay? And they are right now, like, you know, observing their own feelings. I'm sensing more of course, for some of you, I feel this person is like, you know, watching their social media, your social media or something. But for most of you, I sense this person is in the mode of observing their own feelings and emotions, right? With the lens of intuition here. They want to do that for some time. I'm sensing with the Observer and the Yin card, they want to, you know, like see the resilience and the strength of their feelings before they come to you. okay? And they are asking, they are being led by spirit. With the number 7 here and this boat, okay, they are being led by spirit. They are having intuitions. And they're also saying that, you know, they are learning to go with the flow. I think this person, perhaps, you know, has been very passionate and, you know, has been very quick to take action at one point. But now, I think this person is kind of, you know, like learning to go with the flow, to go with the tides, you know, and not hurry things up. So the energy that I'm getting is of your person kind of like mulling over their emotions at this time. Let's see some more. I'm looking at advice for you guys regarding this connection. So let's ask spirit about the advice. Okay. That's a lot, but I'm going to take this one. Okay, breathe. Okay, yeah guys, so the advice for you guys regarding this connection. Okay, I generally don't read reversals, but I'm going to take this as a reversal because this, I don't know, somehow it fits. Right? So the advice for you guys is to kind of, you know, release any intensity here. Okay? With the passion card upright, I think both of you are like very attracted to each other. There's a lot of passion here, a lot of intensity, a lot of like impatience also I'm getting, you know, to sort of get together, to experience this you know, connection, maybe even to be physically intimate with the person. So the advice from spirit here is to sort of tame down your passion. All right, take a deep breath and release, right? And sort of, you know, like sort of become calmer, okay? Right now, let that person take the lead. I did say in one of the cards here that they are the one who are going to come, you know, out with this, whatever they feel. So I sense, guys, that, you know, here, you need to take a deep breath and just relax with the intensity, with the impatience, with the passion, you know, just relax. The second thing that I'm seeing here is celebration dance. They also want you not to get too hung up on this connection. They want you to enjoy your own life, you know, like celebrate yourself. Maybe the way you are going to, you know, release tension is by dancing, okay? Maybe dancing is going to make you release your, you know, like intensity or tension. Maybe like, you know, going for a nature walk or something is going to release tension. So, you know, spirit wants you to relax on this. This person is looking at a way to come to you, and they will, right? You don't have to do anything here, pile number one, okay? Just relax, take a deep breath, and, you know that everything positive is going to happen in this connection, because this person does want that. They're just trying to work that out, okay? So with that, I'm going to end this reading for pile one. I hope it resonated, guys. Okay guys, so for pile number two, what does your person want to tell you right now? Pile number two is this black and spotted color stone. I'm not sure what it is, but this is what it is. So pile number two, let's see what your person wants to tell you right now. What does pile number two's person want to tell them right now? Okay. Six of Pentacles, the Hanged Man, the Empress, and Nine of Pentacles. All right. Right, guys, what I'm getting from these cards is that your person is trying to work. I think you guys are in some sort of separation or some sort of a stagnant period where there's not a lot of communication. Maybe your person has withdrawn or is quiet, you know, perhaps, you know, even in like a shell or something like that, right? So in this pause, you know, I'm hearing that in this pause period, your person is working on their independence. All right. They are working on self-love. All right. Your person is working on self-love. They want you to know that. I do sense that your person was kind of like out of balance at one point of time, because with the Six of Pentacles, they're trying to get into balance. You know, at the bottom of the deck, we have the Five of Cups. That means either in this connection or in previous connections, your person has probably had the tendency to overgive, or perhaps they have had the tendency to not be very balanced, you know, to not be very independent. I'm sensing codependent connection here. You know, your person probably has the tendency to become codependent, or you have a tendency to be codependent on your person. And so it goes both ways here. Please apply it as it fits. Either your person wants to tell you that they are working on codependency, or they want to tell you to work on codependency in this pause period. All right. For a lot of you, I'm sensing that, you know, your person is kind of taking a break away from you right now, because you know, they want to be single for some time. You know, they want their space. Now, that does not mean that your person doesn't love you or anything, because the Empress shows up here. Your person thinks of you as their partner, their ideal, someone who is beautiful, someone who is, you know, they're equal. They want to give a lot to you as well. But you know, one can't give if one doesn't, one is not fulfilled in themselves, right? So I'm sensing that your person is kind of working on themselves right now, so that they can come into balance and give you more, all right? They do consider you. For some of you, I'm sensing like your person is kind of building up to sort of take this connection to the next level. All right, in this pause, your person is sort of, you know, thinking of taking this connection to another level here. Okay, and they want to kind of level up or something like that within themselves before they go ahead and do that, right? So let me see some more. So let's clarify this Nine of Pentacles. Okay, so what do we have here? We have Two of Cups, okay. We have the King of Swords, the Three of Swords, Ace of Cups, Emperor, and Knight of Wands. Yeah. So guys, there is a lot of love here, okay, with the six of pentacles here and the two of cups here and the empress here and the ace of cups. There is genuine love that your person has for you. There's a lot of love, but your person is taking a break, and it might be hurting you. And it's also possible that, you know, you guys had some sort of an argument, and in you know, like a rush of temper or something like that. They said something or you said something, and now, you know, it's like time for a break because, you know, stuff happened, right? For some of you, I'm also getting that, you know, your person being silent and taking this, you know, like space away from you all of a sudden, perhaps, you know, this pause in the connection when it was going so well, you know, it seemed so abundant, and all of a sudden your person is taking a pause. You know, it's kind of breaking your heart. All right, it's kind of breaking your heart. There might be tempers rising, but you know, your person wants to tell you to please be patient with them. They are not speaking out. For some of you, I'm also getting that maybe your person has been hurt by something you said or did. There might be inequality issues. I'm hearing that, like, maybe your person feels lesser than you or something like that, because, you know, we have the Empress here and then the Emperor here. So this person is coming up as the Nine of Pentacles, so they want to actually build up to being the Emperor. I'm feeling some sort of ego issues here somehow. You know, maybe something happened and, you know, your person's ego got hurt. Maybe they thought that, you know, they were not in the same status as you, financial status, professional status. They were not up to mark. Because with the Six of Pentacles also, you know, they're working on, you know, balancing out in every area, right? They want to become the Emperor to your Empress. So there seems to be, like, you know, this pause or this, you know, heartbreak. I am sensing that pain energy, either from you or from both of you or from just them. Something like that happened, and now your person is kind of, you know, like trying to build up, because this was a clarifier for Nine of Pentacles, right? So they are trying to sort of, you know, like build up to become at your level. All right, you know, so that they can match up to you. There is a lot of love, guys, with the Ace of Cups and Two of Cups. There is a lot of love here. There is also passion here. You know, they want to do something. They want to, and it's because of you that this person is wanting to get this stability in their life. Otherwise, perhaps they would not have worked so much. You guys are so intertwined with each other, if you notice, with this Two of Cups. I don't think your person can stop thinking about you. They are actually quiet right now, I'm sensing. They're bottling up their feelings. This pause is hurting them as well. They want to let you know that, but there is something about, you know, like an ego hurt here. Okay, so maybe you guys are facing that because of, you know, you're facing the pain, or you're facing the separation, and that's because of some sort of an issue with ego here, or equality, right? Now I want to see what is this, what else do they want to tell you, actually, because this is quite clear about what really happened. Sorry. Gosh, I could just pick this up. Okay, so what else does pile two's person want to tell them? Yeah, we get the King of Swords again. They are being quiet, guys. Yeah, king of swords, three of wands and six of wands. Yeah, right. Like I said, you know, this is something about your person wanting to be more stable, to achieve some sort of victory so they can come back and show it to you guys that, you know, they are accomplished. Until then, maybe, you know, they are quiet or something like that. For some of you, I'm even getting that maybe your person has some sort of a tendency to get a one up on you, you know, like maybe they want you to come to them and then they're going to feel like really good about it. I mean, a very childish thing, of course, but for some of you, I'm getting that also. But mostly I'm getting that your person wants to prove themselves to you, okay, which is the reason why this pause has happened. They are working and they're very close to sort of, you know, becoming the kind of person or getting into the kind of circumstances or position that they want. All right, they're very close because three of wands, and the ship is coming in, right? So I'm getting that your person is very close to achieving their goals, okay? Also, it's very close to union here, right? Because it's, you know, maybe for some of you it's 3 weeks or 3 months or something like that. Before that you might not hear from them, but after that all of a sudden I sense your person is just going to come and like kind of sweep you off your feet or something like that. Yeah, because at the bottom of the deck I have like the knight of the king of cups, right? And top of the deck we have the ten of cups. So yeah, this is about your person. I want to keep these cards here. Your person loves you a lot. Pile two, there is a lot of love here, okay? But there is something to do with stability, financial stability perhaps, professional stability. For some of you, I'm even hearing that, you know, it is to do with inheritance issues, family related money, you know. I'm also hearing a relocation for some of you. I mean, there are some pretty major things that your person has to resolve. And they are kind of taking their time out right now. They don't know what to discuss right now because they're working through it. And they are not the kind of person who's going to, you know, like kind of keep you updated like step by step about what's going on. They are the kind of person who's going to come to you when the job is done and then tell you that, you know, the job is done, hey, you know, let's go on ahead, okay? So this is what I'm seeing, that your person wants to tell you to be like, you know, patient right now. Just be patient with them. Do not judge them. There is a lot of love and they don't want you to feel heartbroken either. Okay, they don't want you to feel heartbroken either because, you know, they are not doing this deliberately to hurt you or something like that. This person seriously wants to work things out, you know, with the Ten of Cups and the King of Cups. This person cares for you very deeply, very, very deeply. Okay. Now let's see what else. What actions can we expect from your person in the future? Okay, we have the High Priestess, the Wheel of Fortune and the World. Wow, this is so cool, guys. I love this. So for some time with the High Priestess, I sense your person is going to be quiet, guys. Okay, they are, like I said, still trying to work things out right now, and so they are going to be a little quiet right now. You might not hear from them. Two times we have the King of Swords and then we have the High Priestess, so there is going to be quiet right now. But very unexpectedly, your person is going to come and kind of, you know, turn your world upside down. Alright, they are going to come up with a resolution. The World is about completion, about resolution. Whatever the issue was, whatever was hanging in the air, whatever was not resolved, your person is going to come one day and suddenly, you know, unexpectedly resolve everything and tell you that it's all resolved. Alright, So this could happen. It is definitely happening this year, I feel, because we have 2021 and the world card is a number 21. It could happen in the 10th month, right? Which is maybe like October or 10 months from now, you know, take it as it resonates. But this year, I do sense your person is going to make something major happen. All right. That is their next action. They want to give you a resolution and a good one. All right. So that you don't have to worry. So that you guys can go ahead and enjoy this, you know, 10 of cups. So your person is planning something major, some major actions towards you. Pile number two, the bottom of the deck, we have the lovers, right? So once again, like I'm seeing, yeah, seven of pentacles at the top of the deck. So this means that your person, there is no doubt about the love. Two of cups, ace of cups, the lovers, there's a lot of love here, okay? But you guys need to be patient. With the seven of pentacles here, you need to be a little patient with your person. They are working towards some sort of a resolution, pile number two, okay? And once so they are going to be a little quiet, so you need to, like, you know, just give them that time. All right, I do sense for a lot of you this is about either the person's family, family issues, resolving family issues, or property or financial stability issues, career or profession or relocation issues. Some really big stuff is happening here with your person. They're trying to resolve some big stuff, so it's not something petty. All right, so just be a little patient with your person. All right, now let's see the oracle. Oh wow, that was quick. Right, deep knowing, chop wood, and here and now. Yeah, that's pretty much it. With the High Priestess card here, with the High Priestess and the deep knowing, you know, it's like you guys know it, okay? You guys know, I mean, this is the advice from the spirit. You guys know that this connection is here to stay, all right? It is something very strong. It's a deep inner knowing that you have about your connection. Also number seven, right? So spirit is saying go within and trust your intuition. All right, trust your intuition, trust your deep knowing about this connection, right? And we also have, you know, chop wood. So, you know, like, concentrate on the day-to-day chores, your day-to-day tasks. Look at the small things that your person has done or is doing. Do not look at, like, you know, the really, really big picture right now. Stay in the here and now. All right, like, the past is the past, the future is going to come. Try to be in the moment, try to concentrate on you know, day-to-day tasks right now, because your person is you know, working on something big, and you know, you kind of pressurizing them at this point about it is not going to help. All right, stay with your deep knowing, concentrate on this, you know, small things in life. Let your person, I'm hearing spirit say, let your person handle the big things. You stay in the here and now, all right? You don't have to think of the future right now. Your person is handling it. Your person is in charge of it. Pile number two, okay? Breathe at the bottom of the deck, right? Take a deep breath, okay? Relax. Everything is looked after. Everything is going to be fine. Your person is going to ensure that it's going to be fine, okay? I'm going to get some more oracle. Yeah. wow, like was I just telling you guys that, you know, it's all going to be fine? It is all going to be fine. There's going to be a completion. We have the world card also, right? Somewhere we had the world card as well, I think. Where was that? I don't really remember, but I don't know. This is the world card actually, right? Things are going to come to a completion. Things will be fine. You know, just hold on. Spirit is saying, just hold on, just a little bit more, right? Breach. There is going to be a breakthrough. There is going to be a breakthrough that your person is going to bring towards you. And you need to be in this energy of being effortless, right? You need to go with your intuition. You don't need to do anything. This is what I was telling you. You know, like do the small day-to-day things. Be in the here and now. Make this journey effortless. Because, you know, your person is the one who is, you know, bringing about this completion for you guys, right? We had the world card also and we have completion. So this is going to happen. It's destined to happen. You know, your union with your person is destined to happen. There are a few hiccups. There is something that your person is thinking about, trying to work out, and they are waiting for some sort of a breakthrough right now, pile number two. So just wait for that, right? Make it effortless for yourself as well as for your person. You know, do not push it. And yeah, I think pile number one also had this card here as an advice. Celebrate life, celebrate yourself, celebrate life, dance maybe to let go of tension, to make things more relaxed. But just let go, guys, let go, you know, because I sense this is in the hands of the universe, right? I mean, I have at the top of the deck, I have fairies, earth magic. There is something divinely guided about this connection. With the deep knowing card and the earth magic card here, there is something very divinely guided about this connection. And, you know, I'm getting that it's not even in your person's hands or your hands. It's actually in the hands of the divine. Both of you are being guided to make certain choices, to do certain things so that things become more effortless on your journey, but mainly there is going to be a completion here in this connection, guys. Okay, this is what Spirit wants to tell you. You will have your Ten of Cups. This is destined for you. We did have the Wheel of Fortune here as well and the World. So this is destined to complete. You're destined to have your Ten of Cups. You just need to make your journey a bit more simple until this breakthrough happens, when, you know, both of you can come into union. You have that deep, go by your deep knowing, right? Go by your intuition on this. Okay, guys, so this was the reading for pile number two. Okay, so pile number three, what does your person want to tell you right now? So this is the rose quartz, okay, the pink stone. So let us see, I'm going to be shuffling on camera today, guys. So let's see what comes up, what your person wants to tell you right now, pile three. Let's see. Okay, let's see. Wow, like all of the piles got Ten of Cups. This is amazing. This is the first card that came out. Ten of Cups, beautiful. Okay, King of Pentacles, Five of Swords, Page of Cups, and Two of Swords. All right, let's see what's happening here. I think for some of you, for quite a few of you, or for some of you, I'm sensing that this could be your partner, your husband or wife, because we have 10 of cups. Please excuse me. Because we have 10 of cups and king of pentacles, right? So this could be like a partner, a husband or something. And I'm sensing that there's probably been some sort of a fight or something, and some argument, some dispute, some quarrel, and you know, maybe you are blocked off or they are blocked off or something. But your person might not be really very vocal with you right now, might even be acting kind of rigid. I'm seeing they might be acting kind of rigid with you. They're not budging from their stance. Okay, and you know what they want to tell you is that they are actually dying for you to come and kind of patch up. I don't know, I'm getting that, guys. I know it's not, I mean, this is what they want to tell you, right? I mean, you don't have to accept it, right? But your person, they want to sort of, you know, like they're a bit of an egoist, I feel. You know, they are probably like, you know, like kind of acting blocked off, or they are emotionally blocked off. They do want to come towards you, but I am sensing that, you know, there is more of an energy of them wishing that you would come forward. All right. I mean, that's what they want to tell you, actually. Pile number three. Okay. With the bottom of the deck, we have the High Priestess. So yeah, your person is keeping quiet. They are keeping their feelings under wraps. Maybe they are, they're resisting this connection for some reason. Maybe because of this dispute or this disagreement that you guys had, you know, they are kind of resisting this connection. For some of you, I'm also seeing that maybe your person thinks that you are the one who's, you know, being very rigid or being blocked off due to some reason, either emotionally blocked off or mentally blocked off, you know, like, there is also an energy of either one of you having to take some sort of a decision. You know, perhaps I'm getting for some of you that maybe you or they might have asked for some sort of a commitment, okay, and one of you was not able to really, you know, tell or sort of commit, you know, as per the other person's expectations, and that caused some sort of a disagreement. Maybe one person wanted to keep it light and the other person wanted to keep it to sort of have a commitment, right? So I mean, on this side, I'm seeing the energy of like, you know, wanting to take it slow, wanting to take small steps. And on this side, I'm seeing very solid energies of, you know, commitment, partnership, you know, the whole hog. And in between, we have this Five of Swords. So there is some clash here, you know, between you and your person. So take it how it resonates. Who is the one who is, you know, wanting to take it slow, and who's the one who is wanting to take it fast? So let's clarify about this Five of Swords. Wow, that was a lot that fell out. I don't think I want so much. Let's see. Okay, we have Page of Swords. Mm-hmm. Five of Pentacles and Four of Cups, right? I do sense this argument or something was about someone being left out in the cold, someone kind of, you know, like kind of even looking at someone's social media and seeing that the other person's quite hale and hearty. And while, you know, one of you was sitting there despondent and bored, and you know, there is something, there is that energy. Someone was left out in the cold here, right? And perhaps for some of you, I'm even getting that, you know, maybe you know, one person saw something on the social media of another person. You know, maybe you caught some pictures or something of them on social media, or they did. So this argument or something was because of you know, one of you feeling left out in the cold, and kind of, you know, there's this energy of misunderstanding here. Okay, misunderstanding. So let's see what else does your person want to tell you. Definitely they do want to tell you that they are blocked off right now. They wish that you would come because, you know, they feel that you have misunderstood them, that they didn't have any bad intentions. But let's see some more. I'm a little intrigued here. There's something going on. So we have the Eight of Pentacles, we have Queen of Swords, okay, Seven of Cups, the Tower, Nine of Swords, and Eight of Swords. My God, there is so many swords here. You know, I'm getting that there was some major dispute here with the Tower. I think you and your person were both very invested in this connection. Okay, I'm not really seeing that, you know, anybody was cheating or something like that. Bottom of the deck, we have the Empress. So yeah, your person does consider you like, you know, almost like partner material, or you consider them that. Top of the deck, we have Ace of Cups. So there is love here. There is investment here. Maybe you guys have been in this connection for a while. Maybe you are even married or something, you know. But someone was too analytical here. Right, with the Eight of Swords, Nine of Swords, Queen of Swords, somebody wanted to you know, be in control. I'm sensing it is your energy, pile three. Maybe you kind of, you know, like were feeling that everything was up in the air. Maybe, you know, it's just a scenario, please apply it as it fits. Maybe you asked your person for a commitment and they couldn't give it right now, and they wanted to take it a little slow. And you thought that everything was up in the air, nothing was, like, there was no commitment or something, and you guys were just going on and on, and you probably, you know, like, were a bit controlling is what I'm hearing. Please don't get triggered. I mean, you know, like, this is just a general reading. So maybe you were a bit controlling, maybe you interrogated your person, maybe you overthought, or vice versa. I mean, please apply it as it fits. But something caused this Tower moment to happen. All right? Something caused this Tower moment to happen. So there might be like a distance right now between both of you. All right? So yeah, this is definitely like a complicated case. And I'm feeling that your person wants to tell you this, that, you know, you were looking too much into things, or they were looking too much into things, and it all came crashing down because of that. Because maybe at the time that you demanded some answers, they didn't have it. You know, they had a lot on their plate. You know, they were up in the air. They were very invested. They are very invested in this connection, I am sensing. Right? But it's like, in terms of any kind of concrete plans, I don't think they had too much to offer. It was all up in the air, and maybe that is the way that's the reason, you know, like, you kind of walked away or something, and now your person is like all caught up in their mind, you know, in their head and in their emotions. In fact, more so in their head. It's like they're not feeling very good. they're not feeling very good. Pile number three. Okay, let's see some more. How is pile three's person feeling about them right now? So yeah, there you go, five of wands. This person, guy or girl, you know, they are like all up in their head, you know. Eight of swords, nine of swords, tower, five of wands, so many clashing thoughts, you know, like they're very upset, very disturbed right now. They want to let you know that they are trying to come into some sort of balance here, you know, because there's just way too much happening in their head. There is a sense of, you know, we did see that energy in the beginning also, like, you know, there is this wanting, they are wanting you to come and apologize or something like that. I'm just telling you what they want you to do, pile three. Okay, this does not mean that they are right, you know, and you're absolutely free to act the way that you want to, right? But your person like wants to have a bit of an ego massage. It's what I'm getting. Okay, they would like feel awesome, you know, if you would come and apologize or kind of patch things up with them. With the nine of pentacles, I feel they are taking some alone time. Okay, they are sort of, you know, like wanting to be independent, wanting their space right now. They want, you know, they're probably acting like very aloof at this time, for you guys, okay. With the four of pentacles, your person is thinking about you. They are thinking about you. There are constant thoughts about you that your person has, okay. In fact, they are not very they're not even concentrating on what are the things ahead of them, in front of them. They are constantly thinking about you, feeling probably despondent, worried, anxious. You know, why have you not called? I mean, it's almost like a mirroring thing going on. You know, they don't want to come out, you don't want to come out, both of you probably want the other person to make the first move. That's what I'm getting. They are putting themselves up, they are, you know, putting their nose to the grindstone. They're sort of working on it. They're very invested. We have two eight of pentacles here. They are very invested in this connection. Okay, whether they are committing or not, this person is invested. All right. But it's like, you know, they're still at eight, right? You want the 10 perhaps, and they're still at eight. Okay, so your person is probably thinking about what to do, right? They might even be drowning themselves in work because there's so much of mental activity happening here. With the moon card here, I'm seeing that, you know, your person is very confused about their direction. They want to tell you that. Pile number three, I sense you people are, you know, like very objective, very analytical. You want things straight up, you know, and clear. And your person is unable to give you any clear answers right now, which is probably the reason why, you know, some sort of dispute has happened. Your person's feeling very, like, you know, confused. They're not able to give you answers. They're missing you. Here with the moon card here, they're missing you terribly, okay? I mean, they are sensing that gap here. And yes, they're not exactly acting very nice if they're, you know, like showing up as the nine of pentacles here. They're not really acting very nice, you know, but I guess your person's really confused. I don't know why. I'm just getting that they are very emotional about you, but they're very confused about the direction that they want to take this connection in. They are invested, yes, but they haven't thought about where they want to sort of, you know, steer this, okay? And yeah, then we have the 10 of pentacles. Like, you know, this person probably, for some of you, I'm getting that this person probably has family issues. Okay, like maybe the family would not support you guys getting married. You know, maybe there's some cultural differences or background related, some differences. All right. However, with the Ten of Pentacles, they do have this plan. I mean, they are at 8 right now. They do have that plan, but in the middle with the moon here, I'm sensing they don't know how to get here. They're still working that out. And then this has happened, you know, this little dispute or whatever gap has happened between you guys. And, you know, now this person is literally feeling like pressured. You know, I'm seeing that this person is feeling pressured. You know, they want to complete this cycle, you know, of being confused, and just, they just want to sort of, at the top of the deck, we have the King of Cups as well. So it's not like your person doesn't care about you, but there's some gap that has happened and your person doesn't know how to bridge that gap to get back into this harmony, you know, with you. They're working at it, however. They are working at it, okay? I want to see what are their next actions towards you. Let's see. Okay, that's a lot. I want a little bit. Okay, let's see. We have Four of Pentacles. So yeah, they are going to be a little closed off for some time, I sense. Eight of Cups, so yeah, this is them sort of like, you know, for the moment, kind of taking a break. For the moment, taking a break, because there's so much going on mentally for this person. They're very anxious and, you know, so much is buried within. They just want to take some time out and, you know, think, I think. And then Page of Cups and Ace of Wands, yeah. So your person is going to come back, guys. They are going to come back with a sweet and small gesture, maybe a message, maybe a call, and then, you know, launch you guys off into this new beginning. So this person does want something, some new beginning with you guys. Okay, they are going to approach it with, you know, with a small gesture. I don't think, because, you know, at the bottom of the deck, we once again have King of Cups. So, you know, this person really cares about you. They really care about you, but they don't have any plan of action here. And just be careful, because top of the deck, we have Five of Swords. So this is like a bit of a tough dynamic here going on, because I sense from these cards that you want something, okay, that both of you care equally for each other. There is a lot of love here, a lot of concern. But your person or you, I mean, please take that, please apply it as it fits. Either of you don't have like a proper plan, okay, of the future. Or if it is not about the future, if you guys are married and together, then there has been some separation, some gap, and, you know, either of you don't know how to bridge that gap, okay? So however, your person is going to walk away for some time, take a break from this connection for some time, and after that come to you to start off this new beginning. So this connection is going to return, but I really feel that your person needs some time out. You know, they're way too much in the head, you or your person. So let's see, what does spirit have to say about this? Come to the edge, and why? Yeah, there needs to be some leap of faith here, okay? Either from your person's side or from your side. If it's from, you know, like depending on the situation, one of you has to take a leap of faith and probably, you know, do something in this connection, you know, get it going again, you know, restart it again, reconnect again, or take some important decision where you don't have all the answers. You know, I mean, here I'm seeing with the Y that, you know, there's a lot of questioning going on. There's a lot of mental energy, either your person or you, you know, too much of mental energy. Like, let's just take, for example, like, you know, you want, like, you know, something concrete to happen. You want perhaps a commitment from your person, and you know, your person is unable to give it right now, like we saw, and you're probably asking, why are you even in this connection, right? But so you need to take a leap of faith here, okay, and kind of be in this connection, decide to be in this connection, or decide to walk out. Okay, I'm going to see some more. Yeah, blessed, right? I mean, there is something very beautiful about this connection. I mean, both of you are, like, you know, equally invested in it, equally involved in it. It's a blessed connection. Perhaps it has been brought together by the universe. I'm seeing that you need to take a leap of faith towards the universe, towards trusting the universe to, you know, sort of bring this connection back together, rather than, you know, questioning your person. If it is the case of your person, you know, if they are the ones who are questioning too much about how they're going to make this work or something like that, and they don't have a clue, they don't have a direction, they need to take a leap of faith, and they will take a leap of faith in the future, because there is something about this connection which is blessed. You know, it is a destined sort of connection. I am just sensing that with this Y energy here, I think this gap is very much required in this connection, because, you know, there are certain lessons that both of you have to learn in the interim. Okay, both of you have to learn some lessons in the interim, and that is the reason why you know, you guys are in this whatever confusing state. Now I'm just going to look at another oracle. Milky Way perspective. Yeah, like I was saying, you know, there needs to be a change of perspective here, either from the Y card and perspective. There needs to be some change of perspective here, either from your side or from your person's side. And then vision quest. This is like with the Y, the perspective, and the vision quest. This is like a journey, guys. This is a very, I'm sensing this is a very intense sort of soulmate, twin flame, triggering type of connection. Okay, it's intense, but it also brings a lot of shadow work here, you know. It's a quest. It's a quest for true love. You need to ask yourself a lot of questions. You need to shed certain perspectives, shed certain, you know, beliefs, and get your mind in the right perspective. And sort of, you know, hand it over to the universe to a large extent, I feel, right? I'm going to get some more cards here, because this is interesting. Passion, yeah, there's a lot of passion here, a lot of intensity in this connection. I feel like, you know, that it could also be impatience on either of you people's side. So there needs to be some sort of perspective that needs to be gotten here. Okay, oops, all right. Yeah, full moon completion. There is going to be a resolution here. There will be. Even pile 2 had that. You know, maybe you guys were a little mixed up. There is going to be some completion here. There is going to be some resolution here. But there is reflection. See, I mean, do you see this? There is some deep reflection needed here, guys. Look at this. Perspective, reflection, why? I mean, this is definitely about, you know, like shadow work, healing, you know, looking at your own reflection. Like maybe you two are like, you know, mirror images of each other. You're mirroring each other, so you trigger each other. You know, there are certain parts of you that, you know, are reflected in this person and you don't know that, you're unaware. And so, you know, all these things happen. I also got these two cards falling out, submerged and ebb and flow. Yeah. So you need to like kind of ebb and flow with this connection. You cannot dictate the course of this connection. It's like an iceberg. Okay. There is so much more to this than you can understand. Ask, you know, maybe you should check past lives, maybe you should check Akashic records or something like that. There is so much submerged here. That is the reason why you guys are having all these issues. It's not just about some petty, you know, small decisions. There's a lot here. And this is not a connection that is like, you know, you need to kind of be flexible here, ebb and flow. It's not always going to be, it's a very intense connection, I sense, very passionate as well. It has, you know, I'm hearing that, you know, the universe dictates the ebb and flow of this connection. So you have to surrender sometime. This is something big, guys. Okay. This is not a very simple connection. It's complex. Okay. But it's also very interconnected. So they're asking you to kind of, you know, be flexible here in terms of this connection. Be flexible. A lot of things are going to be revealed to you as time goes by in this, right? There's going to be a lot of self-reflection. There needs to be, you know, a change of perspective as well. And, you know, that's how, you know, after all of this, after all this work, it is going to reach some sort of completion, whatever that completion is. Okay, it is going to reach a completion and it's going to be great because top of the deck we have summer solstice, so hopefully it's going to be something you know, very positive. But at the bottom of the deck we have dream time, creation, meaning you create from the decisions that you take, from the perspectives that you have. You are going to create, you know, this connection, the resolution to this connection, right, guys? So with that, I'm going to end. I hope you found this useful. I used a different format because I wanted to do something different, you know, right now. So I hope it resonated. Thank you so much, guys. Bye-bye.